What's up, guys? We are back on Pokemon Showdown 4, I believe. Episode 9 we're on, if I'm not mistaken, of Road to Top 10 in the UU tier. Now, today I'm using a team that my boy Newbreed actually used. It's a really cool team. I believe it was made by Cam, so shoutouts to Call of Lochi. And yeah, it's based around Spexian Mega. Nice para support. It's a pretty nice and balanced team. I like it very much. But before I actually get into today's video, I just want to give a quick shout out to the winners of the official ladder tour cycle one, basically the 8-day laddering. So rank one, Teletubby, whatever. Number two, my boy Fully Cully FOCL. Number three, another friend of mine, Pridey. Number four, Anti Kratos Mana, another friend of mine. The Ender, number five, another friend. Tessong, another friend. Number six, Bengay, another friend. And number eight, we got Shake It Up, another boy. So yeah, congratulations to all of you that basically qualified for the official ladder tour happening in the actual playoffs and stuff like that. So congratulations to all of you that actually qualified, and I'll be giving shout outs to everybody who qualifies. Again, cycle two just went up. I probably will or should leave a link in the description, but it's 3 a.m. right now and I'm gonna be uploading this when I wake up after it renders. So if I don't, I'm sure Chimpact will. So yeah, I'm just gonna leave that on him. Anyway, let's look for a battle. Thank you everybody for the continued support, the likes, the comments. I really, really do appreciate it. And yeah, if you're not already doing so, follow me on Twitch. I will be streaming Thursday, I believe. I'm gonna be staying home before I go to school, so I'll be streaming Thursday morning and a bit in the afternoon, and hopefully at night. We'll see how things go. So I'm just gonna pause it until we find a UU match, and we'll be right back. All right, so we have found a battle. I'm just gonna lead off with Spexian Mega because I am Tinted Lens, which basically, if it's not super effective, it'll be doing neutral damage. So he has nothing that wants to take Bug Buzz from this thing. It'll do neutral damage to this, do neutral damage to this. Actually, Flurries will probably eat it up, but I am Choice Specs, timid though not modest. I'm gonna hit this thing with a Bug Buzz, probably bring it down to 30, if not do 90 something percent, as he red cards me out into Togekiss, which is honestly amazing because I have the Defog right here and I can go right for it. I don't think I lose much from doing that, as he decides to go for spikes. That's completely fine by me. Again, to be honest, I could just go for this, the air slash right here and then defog on something, because he has nothing that can knock me out in one hit at all, actually. Yeah, none of his team can knock me out. It doesn't have enough offensive pressure. Even with poison jab on Haxorus, it won't be able to knock me out, even if it is choice banded. Plus, I will be able to thunder wave it. I'm going to thunder wave this Arcanine before I actually decide to defog away his hazard. Yeah, I'm a thunder wave because I am physically defensive, so I should be able to take a flare blitz and or wild charge. If he wants to go for some sort of status move, it might be a bulky Arcanine just because his team is a bit weak to Victini. He ends up going for the close comet though. I guess he predicted my Swampert. I guess it doesn't really matter too much that I got off the thunder wave on him, just because what? Did you guys see how fast that happened? This man just left. He did have Umbreon though that he could go out into, so what I'm gonna do is pause it until we find another one. Maybe he'll come back with this one, and yeah, we'll be right back. He just left so fast. Alright, so we won this battle, but we got another one just as quickly. This guy has a bunch of threats on his team. I actually just want to lead off with my Swampert, because I want to lead off with Ampharos, because it can basically Volt Switch out versus anything. It's my safest lead if he does decide to lead off with his Victini right there. Now, this is actually a bit threatening. I'm not entirely sure what type of Kingdra he is. I don't want a Mega Evolve. I could survive one hit. I could probably survive a Draco, to be honest. But we'll go out to my Togekiss. No, he'll probably just go for Hydro Pump, though. But I'm just going to click Dragon Pulse as he goes for Outrage. So I am able to smack this thing with a Dragon Pulse, as now I have the free switch into my Togekiss. I probably should have went out to Togekiss like immediately, because now he could just go out into now Victini basically has free switches, especially because this thing isn't a check anymore. I'm just gonna go for Thunder Wave though, as he ends up going out to Fortress, and though I did power up his Gyro Ball, I am physically defensive and I can go for the para flinch combination with air slash combined with the Thunder Wave. You know, a nice present I just left him. We don't know if he'll be able to attack, so ends up going out to the Blade. I don't know how. I mean, that's fine. I do have Swampert, and I do have Scald, which is a pretty nice move. I also do have Tinted Lens and Mega, which would probably Oko this thing with an Air Slash. So, And I have specs, as you know, I said before. So I'm gonna go for my Stealth Rocks right here, as he's more likely gonna want to go out to Fortress. He could also stay in, to be honest, but he ends up going out to Hydreigon. I don't know if he's packing Flash Cannon, but either way, Togekiss is my best bet, as I don't want to take a Draco from this Hydreigon. I am Special Defensive, and to be honest, I could just tank it and go for the Toxic, but I really don't want him to you know, wear down my Swampert. That way his Victini basically gets free switching. So I'm gonna go for Thunder Wave one more time, as he ends up going out to Fortress. Once again, completely fine by me. I could have went for Air Slash right there. I kind of wanted to double actually into my Yanmega, but I don't think it matters too much, as once again, I could just go right for the Air Slash. It doesn't really matter what he comes in. I'm just getting passive damage on everything, and it's my best possible play, as he actually gets up his Stealth Rock. So that's a bit annoying, but I do... he's still paralyzed, so it doesn't matter that I don't get the flinch. I'm not complaining at all, as he ends up going out into his Diblade, and what's a safe switch? See, I don't want to go out directly into Pert, because I don't want it. I'm going to Air Slash this thing, just in case he wants to double predicting Pert. To be honest, he has nothing to double into predicting Pert. He could also just go for Iron Head, but I don't care. I'll go for Air Slash. What I really want to do, though, is defog away these hazards. Actually, yeah, I'll go for defog. I think defogging is better play. He'll probably go for SD or something anyway. As, yeah, he does end up going for the SD. And unfortunately, I'm probably going to have to risk my Pert right here. But while I do sack, not risk my Pert, but sack my Pert. While I do sack my Pert, I will be getting up Stealth Rocks, and I can just revenge kill him with Yanmega's Air Slash after that. So not too much lost. As like I said, Tinted Lens boosted, easily going to be able to knock out this Diblade. I would go for Bug Buzz, but he does times 4 resist that, meaning he only times 2 resist that, which is a bit annoying. But he has nothing that wants to come in and take a Specs Air Slash, as that does nothing to me, as he actually eats that up. Alright, I definitely underestimated the power of Evilite. I know he does resist that, but it's only, yeah, this is neutral damage. That's crazy, as I'm able to knock him out with the next one. So, the good thing is I'm keeping my Stealth Rocks on the field, and I actually kind of sweep him with just Scarf High Jump Kick at this point. Yeah, I really do. As he ends up going out to Hydreigon, I don't know if he's Choice Scarf or not. I do know if he's Choice Scarf. I don't know if he's Timid. He's Life Orb. I do know that he's Life Orb, though. So, Togekiss once again being the best switch, as he has nothing that wants to come in and take Air Slashes at all. As he ends up hitting me with an Iron Tail. Is that supposed to be damage? That did not look like damage to me. I actually just want to go for the Air Slash, predicting him to want to go directly in the Fortress right here, because I want to keep up those rocks and I want to be able to 2-hit KO him. If he goes out to anything else like Kingdra or anything at all, I don't think he'll stay in with his Hydreigon, especially because I can roost off the damage pretty easily and go for Thunder Wave. I can punish him with that Thunder Wave, so I'm really expecting him to want to switch out right here, and I'd rather not have to bank on a para or a flinch a route when I can just 2-hit KO the incoming Fortress. Of course I have to hit, but Kingdra is also a decent switch in, but it's just a free roost for me, to be honest, so I'm not sure if he would actually do that. Unfortunately, Jirachi is looking a bit useless, as he actually does end up staying in. Either I got predicted or I don't know. Regardless, I can get a free roost versus his Fortress. So what I'll do is I'll sack my Ampharos right here, as he has to either knock me out. Yeah, he has to knock me out, and he'll go down to Life Orb anyway. So yeah, basically he has to knock me out right there. Mega Evolving and clicking Dragon Pulse is definitely my best play. It ensures that he can't roost and he goes down to Life Orb. So that's one big threat gone. As I do have Mien Shao. Now, I'm actually going to calc something real quick. I want to see how much knockoff does to Victini. Mien Shao. I don't really know the calcs. Knockoff does 60 to 71. Okay. That's cool to know. As he ends up going out to Kingdra. Just going to U-turn out because I can knock that thing out. And, I can go out to Jirachi. And I don't think I need rocks to win this game. I'm not sure. I want to bait out the Fortress because I can go for Fire Punch. I can also go for Iron Head. I'd rather go for Fire Punch, though. Actually, no. that's the reason I wanted Fortress in, is so I can get off a roost with my my Togekiss. So yeah, I'm definitely gonna go for the roost right here with my Togekiss, as he ends up getting up his rocks. Completely fine by me, because I can just go for roost right here. Gyro Ball, if he does have it, will be doing a decent amount, definitely, as he ends up going for Volt Switch. So that's nice for me. Definitely nice for me. As Victini ends up coming out. What is my spread? I know I'm defensive, but I don't think I can eat this up. I really don't. What is the Omega doing? But I don't want to sack the Omega because he doesn't get the drops. Yeah, I know I have no switchings. Actually, the Omega isn't bad. I'm going to sack my Jirachi. As he ends up going for Bolt Strike. Interesting play. Definitely an interesting play. But he is Life Orb though, so... Okay, I don't know. I guess that makes sense because he is Life Orb. Unfortunately, he gets a Paralysis, but can't do anything about that. Could have been a potential speed time. I'm just going to go for Fire Punch right here just in case he wants to, yeah, go out into his Fortress as he ends up U-turning out into Fortress. If I get off two Fire Punches, it will be in my favor. As you can see right there, I just did a lot of damage with that. And his Victini is in range of High Jump Kick and or Knock Off, so... Definitely in my favor, and I do break through the paralysis. Yeah, I don't know why he did that, though. He definitely should have just attacked me. But it works out for me. I'm able to get rid of the fortress, and unless this this Entei is, like, some sort of weird variant. And then he goes back out to Victini. Okay, I really did not understand that series of events right there. But I'm not knocking it. Definitely not. Knocking it as he ends up going for Bolt Strike. What is he? Does he really not want to get the drops from V Create? It doesn't matter. I have Mien Shao right there. Yeah, I don't think it matters too much. And I'm debating going for High Jump Kick. I want to see how much it does to Entei. Entei, you offense. High Jump Kick does. All right, KOs. After Rocks, cool. So I have to hit two High Jump Kicks right here. I hit the first one on Victini, which is great. And all I gotta do is hit the second one. Bandit Extreme Speed won't be able to knock me out from Entei. And I can knock him out. And if he does go for the Extreme Speed, Togekiss wins. So I don't think he will go for Extreme Speed. I think he has to go for the Sacred Fire, hoping I miss. And yeah, I do end up landing it. That was a really weird game. Yeah, that was a really weird game. I didn't understand half his plays. But let's look for another battle. And I'll pause it until we find one. Found a battle actually versus a very threatening team. Suicune being a pretty big threat. Snorlax, maybe. I don't know. I think Suicune is just the biggest threat if it's like Krokun. I'm gonna lead off with my Swampert. Kind of expecting him to want to lead off with Noivern. To be honest though, I think Mien Shao is actually my safest lead because it is Choice Scarf. Yeah, unless he's like Choice Scarf Noivern, but that thing has so much speed. Why would you run Choice Scarf Noivern anyway? Yeah, I'm gonna lead off with Mien Shao because I am Choice Scarf, as he ends up leading off with his Fortress. And just gonna go right for the U-turn. If he has Red Card, that's cool. He does not. And I believe I can just go directly into my Togekiss and just defog away these hazards. I'm not sure what he's running, but I want to get rid of these hazards as quickly as possible, as he ends up hard switching into his Snorlax. So Snorlax is actually a pretty annoying Pokemon if it's Curslax. Yeah, it actually is pretty annoying. I do have Folk Splash, which could possibly to a KO. Quotations, I'm holding quotes up right now, but ends up going for Body Slam, and I believe that is Choice Banded. I'm not sure. I'm gonna get on my Stealth Rocks right here as he goes for Body Slam again. He's probably not Choice Banded, he's just offensive in my opinion. But I can just go for Scald just in case he wants to go out into his Fortress. And unfortunately, I probably won't be able to keep up rocks this game, but at least I'm gonna get a kill right now with Mien Shao, if not to a KO something. If he's max defense Fortress, he can live this. But it might be a roll, so I'm going to go for High Jump Kick again. If I hit it and it wasn't a roll, it would have been nice. He gets up his Stealth Rocks. I might just live this game. I might just play this game with us both having our Stealth Rocks. Like, yeah, I don't mind. The Stealth Rocks help me a lot, especially with getting KOs on, like, Raikou and stuff like that. So, speaking of Raikou, he ends up going out into it. This is annoying. I'm going to go for High Jump Kick. I don't think it'll knock him out, but... Oh, it actually does. Wow. I wasn't sure. I mean, Reckless High Jump Kick is nothing to mess around with, but Raikou was a threat. I didn't want to switch on to Ampharos, have it take unnecessary damage. As he ends up going out to Noivern. I don't think Noivern can really punish Togekiss too much, even with Hurricane. But I want to go out to Jirachi just because I can Toxic. as he actually ends up going out to Suicune. So Suicune is a... Alright, we're going to ignore spectators real quick. Suicune is an annoying Pokemon. I do have Ampharos, which is the reason why I saved it. Even at plus 2, Ampharos' Thunderbolt does about 45% to max HP Suicune. So ends up going for Scald, as I can just go right onto my Ampharos, Mega Evolve, and go right for Volt Switch. He has to go out into Snorlax. He could, I guess, potentially Calm Mind, but I don't see him doing that. I think he's going to go out to Snorlax, and by him going out to Snorlax, I basically just get a kill with Mian Chao once again. So Mian Chao comes in, and I think this is AV Snorlax, I'm not sure, but I'm just going to go right for High Jump Kick. He does not have a switch in. This dies. This will possibly get to a KO'd, and I miss. Alright, so that is unfortunate as hell. That really sucks, actually. I guess, you know, it's High Jump Kick, so can't really do much about that. I'm just going to go out to my Jirachi, and I actually click Toxic, predicting Suicune will want to come in, as he actually ends up staying in, going for Earthquake. So you want to dodge the High Jump Kick and also dodge the flinches right here. But I can potentially, I'm saying potentially, because it's not, you know, 100%, I can get back up to about 50%, as he ends up going out to Lucario. Interesting switch, very, very interesting switch, as I can just go for Substitute right here. I do outspeed him, so he ends up going right for the Close Combat. That's exactly what I needed him to do. I need to get that damage off, that way I can go for Fire Punch. The thing is, Suicune could still win late game, especially because I lost my High Jump Kicker, but we'll see. Ends up going out to Noivern. I do have Tokiss, which is relatively safe switching at this point. I don't think he'll go for Hurricane. Yeah, he ends up going for Flamethrower, and it turns out he has Life Orb, so this is actually a threat. I might lose to this thing, as he hits me with Boom Burst. So, biggest threat to my team, gone, as I guess he didn't want to miss Hurricane. Completely fine by that. I'll just be able to, roost off the damage he does, and actually just... I don't want to sack. Kind of want to sack Jirachi. Hopefully he... that sucks. I really want to sack Jirachi right there. But the thing is that Ampharos can still beat Suicune 1v1, so I should be good. Like I said, Ampharos is doing 45% with T-Bolt all the time. So even if Suicune Calm Minds up, gets the plus 2, it'll do 45%, and even if he rests up, he basically has to like crit burn me, as he goes for the Scald, does not get the burn, which is great. Even if he rests up right here, I do 2 at KO him, so I believe that's checkmate. Did I just say checkmate? Whatever, I'm able to get rid of the Suicune. A bit unfortunate that I missed High Jump Kick, but he kind of misplayed. He definitely misplayed. But it works out in my favor, and I'm able to take him out with the Dragon Pulse. So, yeah, good game, dude. And 19 points away from passing Chimpact. This is road to keeping Chimpact out of top 10. 1632, where am I? I'm at 1624, actually. Alright, how much time has gone on? 18 minutes? Let's look for another battle, as we actually find one right away versus a very scary team. Definitely a scary team. The biggest threat being like Victini by far. Though Swampert puts in some work on him. So I'm going to lead off with Swampert. Hopefully this thing doesn't have like knockoff or something. I'm just going to go for Toxic just in case he wants to go out into Chestnut. I mean, this thing definitely has to have knockoff. Hopefully it doesn't have Seed Bomb. As he ends up getting up his rocks. And I missed my Toxic. Unfortunate. But can't do anything about that, as I am able to get it on the Chestnut. He probably has Hail Bell on his Tokiss. I think I played this guy before. I'm not sure. But I'm going to go out to my Tokiss right here, simply because I can defog away his hazards. As he ends up going for Leech Seed. And I'm actually going to go for Thunder Wave, expecting a switch, as he actually stays in and gets me with the damage. That's what we like to call it these days. Unfortunately, I'm in an annoying position. I have to go for Roost as he gets a free switch into Victini. That's why I said it was an annoying position, because yeah, it's definitely annoying for me. I do have Swampert, which can come in, but it's going to be 2 KO'd because I am special defensive, so that's annoying. Ooh, it might not be 2 KO'd, actually. Is this a Scarfic team? Who knows? Just going to hit him with an Earthquake as he ends up going out to Chestnut. Completely fine by me. And, I'm going to go out to Togekiss one more time as he goes for the Leech Seed. And I just want to defog away these hazards. They're annoying. They're definitely annoying me. So I'm going to go for the defog as he actually pulls a switch out into Victini. I didn't expect that because it was so obvious. But the thing is, yeah, Mega just gets a kill after I sack Pert, so I'm fine with that. As he's able to 2 KO me, yeah, so. Yeah, Mega gets a kill, like I said. Well, potentially. I have to flinch his Togekiss to death, but I'm going to go out to my Mega right now as he ends up going out to Togekiss. And that is 32%. I will be Thunder Wave by this thing, definitely. I'm going to go for Air Slash again, though. Yeah, bye. I'm going to go for it again. I don't care. The best play would be switching out to Ampharos, but yeah, bye. I'm sorry, I'm having fun. It's too late in the morning. dead. Counter? Ouch. Not bad. Got rid of his high jump kick switchings. Can sack you to get a free switch into you. Excuse me, a nice and free Dragon Pulse on the incoming Donphan if he wants to go out to Donphan, of course. Looking like my win condition is spamming high jump kick. I did just hack him to death, but I don't care. I really don't. As I do have Togekiss, which could just come in. I'm actually going to go for... Okay, that was a stupid play. But wait. No, wait. It doesn't matter, does it? How do I go from hacking the guy to death and then just choking away a victory? This is my fault. I got a bit too excited right there. I definitely just, like, choked away because I did hack him, so I could have won after that. As long as I got a bit of prior damage on the Victini, and I needed that Pokemon to win. We'll see, though. We'll see how things go. I don't like his team at all. Not bad. Nice chokes. I love how I was flinching his Togekiss to death, though. That was pretty great. Not even gonna lie. That was pretty great. So, Victini comes in, right? My best bet is going for high jump kick and winning every single speed tie with Jirachi later on and flinching him to death. So, going for it. 100%. As, yeah, I that's my best bet. So, that's my win condition. So, I can go out to Jirachi now and I believe just go for the substitute on his either Togekiss or Chestnut switching or even his own Jirachi, to be honest. But I don't know what he'd want to do, to be honest. But, oh, there was no timer on. Turn on. I guess this is my only way of winning at the moment. It's really unfortunate, but that is my way of winning. I have to win speed ties and lose speed ties too, certain speed ties. So we'll see how this goes. He stays in, goes for the V create, completely fine. Just keep getting those drops, bro. I'm completely fine with that. As once again, I can just go for substitute, and I am gonna go for substitute. I guess he's trying to make it that I don't get up a free sub versus him, but like I said, I'm gonna keep going for subs. I don't even know how many V creates he has left. So right here, he goes out to his Jirachi. I should be able to eat up a U-turn if he has a Scarf variant, and I can just go right for the Fire Punch right here. Maybe I'll get a burn. I got the burn. Yeah, bye. I don't think Iron Head will break my sub now that I got the burn, and I should be able to end up with a free sub right now. I'm just gonna go for Toxic, expecting him to want to switch out. As he actually ends up going Chestnut, though, I expected him to go out to Victini, Jirachi. I expected him to switch out because he could have Healing Wish. So, yeah, and once again, Jirachi doing what it tries to do best, which is flinching this guy to death. Hopefully it works out for me. Looks like it is. I don't want to go for Fire Punch because Chestnut is hella bulky, so I doubt it'll be able to knock him out. I have to get this last flinch if I want a chance of winning, as I do end up pulling it out. I'm sorry, guys, but this is my way of winning, so I have to do this. I'm going to go for Sub right here, as he doesn't end up going for the Healing Wish like I expected. And I should be able to Toxic his Victini. As he ends up missing the Bolt Strike, not bad! Guys, basically, this was my only way of winning this game. I had to do this. I know I'm haxing him to death, but this is what I had to do to win. So, you know, I can't justify anything, but like I said, it's what I had to do to win. Or if I even win the game, of course, you know. That's always up for debate. Oh, that's always something that might not happen. I want a speed tie right here. As I end up flinching him, and I believe that should be game because I sack my Togekiss as he knocks me out with the Bolt Strike. Alright, I'm really sorry guys that you had to see that, but that's what I had to do to win. I know it was hacks. I definitely know it was hacks, but you gotta do what you gotta do. And I played how I had to win after all them chokes. I think this is the second time I've hacked this guy in a live. I think I hacked him in the completely opposite. I'm gonna say good game. I was like, wait. Because he got mad last time. I'm not going to say good game. I actually... Nah, that wasn't a good game. I'm sorry, man. Oh, my God. All right. Jirachi pulling through. Like I said, I choked. And then I saw my win condition, which was winning some speed ties, haxing him to death, etc., etc. I hope you guys all enjoyed this episode. It was pretty funny, considering it is 3 a.m. I am now past Chimpact, which is what tennis I play tennis wanted me to do. Let me see. See the ladder. Am I past Chimpact? Yes, I am. Yes, I am. Road to passing Chimpact. We're really close to top 10. I only need about 50 more points. So this could be potentially the second to last episode. Who knows? Who knows? I hope you guys all enjoyed. Leave a like if you did. And until next time, later.